Hello everyone, I am Lucie Cadorel, a second year PhD student in Artificial Intelligence at University Nice Côte d'Azur and a member of Remix research team at INRIA Sofianty-Police in France. In this video, I'm going to present our work about geospatial knowledge in housing advertisements, capturing and extracting spatial information from text, supervised by Andrea Detamanzi, and has been done in collaboration with K-City Labs, a French proptech company. First of all, geographic and spatial information is found in many text-based documents, such as social media, newspaper, or novels. But in our work, we decided to study real estate advertisements as we collaborate with a French proptech company, K-City Labs, but also because real estate advertisements have several advantages to extract spatial information. First, they generally provide information about properties' location, environment, as the location is one of the most important factors in purchasing decisions. They provide description of the neighborhood and its facilities. And also, they are a fairly exhaustive and updated source of data, since many areas and cities are found, and often they have an online version that facilitates data collection. Many applications can result from the extracted knowledge. For example, we can locate a property or features as advertisers do not always provide it, the exact location. We can also get insight about valuable labor factors, for example, and in general, information that can help proptech companies to understand the real estate market. So to extract spatial information from text and build a structured knowledge base, we propose a workflow based on two techniques. First, name entity recognition, and then relationship extraction. Name entity recognition applied to geography is called geoparsing. And geoparsing applications are mainly focused on place name or toponym. However, they also have a non-name entities that can describe the location. So we extend geoparsing to non-name entities. Second, we develop a relationship extraction and in particular for spatial relationship. And our last contribution is that the workflow is applied to French text that have limited resources. So, as explained before, geoparsing applications are mainly focused on toponyms that are entities referring to proper name of places. But non-name entities also give information about the neighborhood on the location. For example, in this ad, we have Nice and Promenade des Anglais that are the toponyms. But we also have tram stations, supermarkets, and school that are features, so non-name entities, but they give information about the location of this home. So it's interesting to extract them, and also we can try to infer the exact location of those entities by cross-analysis with other databases and spatial context. We also have two other types of entities, spatiotemporal and mode of transportation. Spatiotemporal is a distance, and it can be spatial, like 4 5 kilometers or 100 meters. It can be temporal, like here, 5 minutes, or a vague distance, like nearby, short distance. We don't know what it means exactly. And finally, the mode of transportation helps to reduce the vagueness of the spatiotemporal entity. So here we have walk that completes 5 minutes. So here we know that 5 minutes is by walking and not, for example, by driving. So now I'm going to present you the first module of our workflow, so the name entity recognition. So we based our approach on a BLSTM CRF architecture, which is a deep neural network architecture, so here. And first we feed this architecture with a 1,200 housing advertisement annotated and extracted from various online advertisements and written in French. And to tackle French problem and specificity of real estate ads, We decided to add an embedding part to the architecture. And this embedding is a global vector composed of the concatenation of the three different text representations. So the first one is a classic word embedding, word to vec, that we train on our corpus of French ads. Then we fine-tune the two pre-trained French models, language models, with our corpus, which correspond to a BLSTM language models. And then we added a Camembert, a French transformer language model, but we did not fine-tune this model due to a lack of a huge training corpus, but it's still really helpful like it is. So to evaluate our model, we computed precision, recall, and F1 score, and compared the proposed model to spacey architecture and different combination of embedding. So we split the dataset into 10 folds and evaluated our pipeline through cross-validation. We first noted that the BLSTM CRF outperforms spacey architecture. Then also we can see that the embeddings like FLIR and Camembert really increase performance, and in particular FLIR and Camembert. But we also added Word2Vec because we saw that the results are more robust with it. So after performing name entity recognition, we extracted relationship between entities. So first we have the housing ads in French, and we perform a name entity recognition and extract dependency graph based on parser speech and dependency parsing. Then we use both results to find the shortest path in the dependency graph between two entities. And we also extract subphrase between entities because words play an important role in the relationship. Then we computed embedding for the subphrase and the shortest path. For the subphrase, it is exactly the same as name entity recognition. And for the shortest path, we modelize it like a sequence, and we apply an embedding model based on sequence to vector. So we use it as input to feed the four classification model based on XGBoost. And we extracted attributes, feature composition, spatial, and mode of transportation. They are both binary classification. So here are the results, and all the classifications get an accuracy above 95%, which is really good. But those results have to be a bit qualified, as they might be biased because of the small and imbalanced classes, especially for the mode of transportation, because we only had a dataset of 216 relations and totally imbalanced. Nevertheless, all in all, our proposed workflow performed well and retrieved spatial entities and relationships. We separately evaluated each model, which does not represent the global performance of the pipeline, but it's still really pretty good. So finally, I'd like to present the next step, which is to get a graph from the real estate advertisement. In our example, I added the part of speech and some dependency parsing that feed the classification models. And here is the graph that we could obtain. So first, we add the house as the subject if we don't have a subject in the relationship, because ads always talk about a property. So here this has a subject, the house, and the predicate is located in. And we have, I added two other spatial relationship, nearby and 5 minutes, but it is the same with short distance. So for nearby, we have the subject, the house, predicate nearby, and the object promenade des Anglais, which is really easy relationship. But for 5 minutes, it is a bit more difficult because it's not a binary relationship, because we also have the mode of transportation, a number of minutes. So here I add the predicate minute, the unit 5, but it could be 10, 15, whatever, and mode of transportation, which is walk. Also, here the supermarkets are 5 minute walk away, but we don't know the name of the supermarket, which is non-named cities. So we added a blank node, but the type of this blank node is supermarkets. And supermarket is a subclass of feature. So here this is a possible knowledge representation that we can get from the ad. So in conclusion, we have proposed two-stage methods to automatically retrieve geospatial information from housing advertisements. A major contribution is the recognition of feature and spatial-temporal entity to better understand the spatial context. And this workflow can be adapted to other types of text and languages by having an annotated dataset. And as future work, we would like to disambiguate the entities, and in particular the toponyms, create a RDF graph and link nodes to other graphs such as GeoNames, OpenStreetMap, or DBpedia. And finally, we want to qualify and quantify the uncertainty and vagueness in the extracted knowledge, and in particular of the spatial terms such as nearby, 5 minutes, short distance, to improve the reliability of the location. So this is the end of my presentation. Thank you for the attention.